So dear students, we have seen linear search in our last lecture, and in this lecture we will see what is binary search. Now, as its name implies, binary search is the search in which the particular array or the particular list will be divided into two parts, and that's why it is called as binary. So binary search is used for searching the element in a sorted array. We have seen linear search in our last section. Now, in linear search, we can search the element though it is not in the unordered, though it is not in the ordered way or sorted way. Means the searching can be done on the unsorted or unordered array. But in binary search, it is necessary to have the array in the sorting form. So if we want to do the binary search on any particular array, the first step is we have to sort the array in the ascending or descending order. It is a fast search algorithm with runtime complexity O log n. Now, as we are dividing the array or the list into two parts, and after that we are doing the search, that's why it is the fast searching algorithm. And the time complexity of binary search is O log n. Binary search works on the principle of divide and conquer. As I said, the particular array is divided into two parts, and then the particular element is searched by finding the mid of the element. That's why the searching time is less over here. This searching technique looks for particular element by comparing the middle element with the another elements. That means when we are doing the searching in the element, this is nothing but your low, this is nothing but high, and by the low and high we find out the mid. So for finding the mid in the particular array, the mid can be found by low plus high divided by 2. Now suppose 0 is nothing but 5 is at 0 position, then 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So these are nothing but the memory locations. So low is 0 plus high is 5. So that is divided by 2. That is nothing but 2.5 means 3. So 3 is your mid in this particular example. So by using low plus high divided by 2, that is equal to mid, the mid is find out over here. Now after finding mid, we know that 20 is your mid pointer. Now this particular array is in the ascending order, and we want to do the binary search, and we want to search the element 25 in this particular array. Now following figure shows how the binary search works. Now we know that 20 is at the mid position of the array. So this plays the important role. So what we will do? We will search the element 25. Now as we are having mid, that is 20, whenever you want to do the search, first we will find out the mid. After finding the mid, the element which we want to search, if it is greater than the mid, we will do the searching in the right hand side. And if the element is less than the mid, then we will do the search in the left hand side. So now as we want to find out 25, and 25 is greater than 20 mid, so we will search in the right hand side of the array. So what we will do? You will search that 20 with 25 with 20, it is the mid. Then you will search 25 with 25, so the element is already found at this particular location. And suppose the element is not present, then you will compare the value, you will search the value till last location, otherwise we will say that the element is not present over here. So binary search starts with the middle element. Linear search starts from the first element, but binary search starts with the middle element. And the it is true if the element is equal to the element that is present in the particular array. So the first step is to do the array in the sorting order.
Second step is to find out the mid by low plus high is divided by 2. Then we will compare the mid with the element. If the element is greater than mid, you will do the searching in the right hand side. If the element is less than mid, you will do the searching in the left hand side. So in this way, the binary search working has been done. So features of binary search. It is great to search through large sorted arrays. It is very efficient for large arrays. The time complexity is very good in binary search because it takes the less time. The time complexity of binary search is O log n, and it is very simple to use. So we have seen already how the steps of binary search are there. So we will assign the left side and the upper side, that is nothing but low plus high, and mid, that is divided. So we will initialize the various variables as low, high, mid. Then we will find out the mid. Then we will compare the item with mid. If the item to be searched is greater than mid, we will do the searching in the right hand side by incrementing the pointer, and if it is less, we will search in the left hand side. So that is how the binary search working take place. Thank you. In our next lecture, we will see with the hashing technique.